Why is keeping quiet? Let him come out. Congress people, they are very much afraid. Contesting 2% in one family, I don't think any problem in it. After the election only, I will come back to you.
The man who led the entire gamut of getting the political party into southern India, the man is a Lingayat strongman, Mr. Yeddyurappa. So thank you so much for joining us today. So how confident are you of BJP's victory?
Compared to 2014 Lok Sabha elections, now popularity is more than 15 to 20% rise because of Modi ji's so many programs. I've got 100% confidence. We are going to win minimum 300 seats in Delhi, in All India level, and minimum 22 seats we are going to win in Karnataka.
Sir, during assembly elections in Karnataka last year, BJP was almost winning, but in the last minute, the Congress as well as the JDS formed the alliance. Similarly, you have so many regional parties, alliances maatkondidare, mate there is Mahagathbandhan also. How do you see BJP's chances? Are there challenges?
You know, very well, we won 104 seats. We lost about 20 seats, very low margin, 500,000 like that. You see the fun of the state. We are 104, we are sitting in opposition party, whereas they won only 37 seats, they are in the ruling party. There, Congress people, they are very much afraid. If Yeddyurappa become the chief minister of Karnataka, it will be difficult for them. That's why they are supported. Now they are suffering like anything. The difference of opinion is going up like anything, you know very well. Number three, entire state, people are not happy about the JDS government rule. He has promised within 24 hours he is going to pay off about 46,000 crores. Whereas so far from last 9 months, he couldn't be able to pay off even 4,500 crores. So false promise. People are fed up and they want to take revenge against JDS and Congress. And 101% this time they are going to support wholeheartedly. AADMK and other political parties also, just now they came and they are going to support us. Particularly in the entire state, SC, ST and OBC, they are supporting us. And that's why I'm full confident that we are going to win 22 Lok Sabha seats in Karnataka.
So, Rahul Gandhi yesterday filed his nomination in Wayanad, and he said that he wants to strengthen the South, the party's presence in the South. Do you see that as a challenge? How do you see Rahul Gandhi in the South?
See, you know very well, Rahul Gandhi is going to lose in the previous constituency. That's why he don't have any confidence. That's why he filed the nomination. And here also they are giving very good fight. And nobody is happy about his contesting from that place also. And he is giving so many false promises which is not at all impossible to implement it. So that's why he may lose even here also.
So what about the Augusta Westland case? Yesterday there were new evidences that were revealed, and Augusta Westland alley, Rahul Gandhi's involvement is there very, very visibly. Do you think that it will work against Congress?
101%, because from last so many months the same thing, discussion is going on. Now it has come to a stage. Definitely it will affect Rahul Gandhi, and not only Rahul Gandhi, entire Congress party.
Sir, were you disappointed when the Karnataka BJP unit suggested that Tejaswini Anand Kumar must get the ticket? But then in the last minute it was Tejaswi Surya who got the ticket. Are you somewhere disappointed?
Not at all, madam, because we have suggested only one name. But last minute they have changed in the center. They have got their own reason. And you know, 2 days back, Amishaji was the rally. Both Tejaswi Surya and also that lady also accompanied with the rally. There is no problem at all. We are all together, and Anand Kumar Mrs. also going to support us. There is no difference of opinion, and I made her state vice president also 3 days back.
So with respect to the BJP, they've always fought against Congress, saying that Congress thrives in dynasty politics, including JDS. But your son is also contesting the Lok Sabha election. Is that not family politics?
Not at all, madam. Because our Raghavendra from last 25 years is in politics. He was an MP, he was an MLA, and again he is contesting. Contesting two persons in one family, I don't think any problem in it. But whereas in Deve Gowda's family, almost all two is elder sons contesting, and also he is also contesting, and also and Kumar Swami wife also is an MLA, and Revan also minister, and Kumar Swami is the chief minister of Karnataka. This type of dynastic politics, people are not going to like it. That's why they are suffering, and you may not be surprised that even Deve Gowda is going to lose in Tumakuru district.
So when it comes to Mr. H.D. Kumaraswamy, he has said that BJP has been involved in political vendetta, IT raids being conducted in Mandya, and also his car being checked all the time. So he's been blaming the BJP.
See, IT raid natural. Yesterday my helicopter, there also they have searched. It's quite common at the time of election. IT raid, you know very well, in the that they have come out openly, more than 360 crores. Hasan district, five important works. Before completing the work, they have given the advance, well in advance, full amount they have paid. Is not a this type of understanding with the contractors. Previously, Modi ji used to tell 10% commission government. Now I am telling you, this is 20% commission government, and so far never even replied for this episode. Kumaraswamy is keeping quiet. Why is keeping quiet? Let him come out.
So you also said that when BJP sweeps to victory in Lok Sabha, BJP will form the government in Karnataka. Will you still stick to that?
My intention was, after Lok Sabha elections, we are going to win minimum 22 seats. At that time, Congress and JDS in fight will be more. What will happen? Let us wait and see.
So will you become the chief minister of Karnataka then?
I don't want to speak anything about that. After the election only, I will come back to you.
Because most of them say that you might go the L.K. Advani way. Just like L.K. Advani was sidelined, that you will also be sidelined.
L.K. Advani is an elderly man, our senior leader. And also yesterday's statement was supported by our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji also. And he has given almost all the opportunities from last so many years. In future also, you will be an elderly man. He is going to advise us the entire country.
Thank you so much, sir. So the fate lies on May 23rd, when we will know what exactly is going to happen with respect to the power at the center. With video journalist Ajay Pratibaraman, My Nation.